Pepper Lovers, welcome to buy my new YouTube video for our creative journey. And in this video, I make a planner spread in my Sidekick planner from Elizabeth Craft Design, designed by Esther Glass. I use book paper for this planner spread. I most of the time use book paper for my planner spreads, but because I like to use book paper as a background, as a base. And we start with a shaker. I want to make a shaker of this page, so I cut out two pages and a hexagon metal die, and I cut out a hexagon in the center of those pages. So I cut out a hexagon in both pages, and in between I use some acetate to hold the sequins for my shaker. I cut the acetate on size. I do this as two times for both pages, and I glue them with my edge shave tape, and then we go on to the next step and fill the shaker with the sequins. Now the acetate is in place on both pages, and I want to glue the pages together now. But first we need some sequins, so I grab some sequins, and I use not too many but not too less. So it's I think this is enough sequins. A little bit more, of course. Yes, okay, this is enough. So now I put the pages together, and then we have a shaker. So this is how I make my shaker spreads in my planners. Now my shaker is ready, and it's time to decorate my planner spread page. But first we start with the background, and I use some distress oxide. This is the color peeled paint. I use a stencil and apply it with my brush application to my page. I use two colors. Second color I use is Seedless Preserves, and I blend them together. So, and that is the beautiful thing about distress oxide. You can blend the colors perfectly with each other, and it gives a beautiful background on your planner spread or your scrapbook layout or card making, of course. And here I use my distress oxide with some water. I mix it with some water and a pencil of a brush. And I made some splatters on my page. And I also did it with the acrylic white ink. I mixed them also with water, and with my brush I made some splatters on my page. And here I had to cut some design paper on size and put it behind my photo. And I want to use some dies, metal dies from Bramble Fox. They have beautiful dies, and I love to work with those dies. I also use them on my scrapbook layouts. But I think they are very easy going also with the planners, to work in your planner spreads. So for this time I used the Bramble Fox dies. Here I start layering my photo with design paper and the dies. And also looking for some die cuts to decorate my page. Here I used a little banner. I cut out from the set, from the first set, second set from Bramble Fox, and I want to use more dies. So here I choose the leaf. It's a very pretty leaf, and I use some green cardstock and cut out two times the leaves with my sidekick, and the leaves I put them behind my design paper and photo for more layer and dimension in my planner spreads. And Bramble Fox has also stamps in the shop, and I love those stamps because they are good for scrapbook layouts or card making or bullet journal, but also in your planner spreads. Here I use the word adventure, and I also will use the word memories, and I stamp them with my Archival ink on white cardstock, and I cut it out with my scissor, and I place them on my planner spread. So now it's time to grab my die cuts for decorating my planner spread. And The die cuts and the paper, design paper I use are from Pink Fresh Studio, Days of Splendor. It's a very beautiful collection from Pink Fresh and beautiful for all, for your autumn pictures. The colors are soft, a little bit purple and mint, but there are also a red and a dark blue in it. So yes, I like the color combination very much of this collection from Pink Fresh. And now here I look through my die cuts and I like this flower and I think, okay, where I wanna put this flower. And yes, I think here it's on the front of the picture. It's a very large die cut, but I like this one, so I think I will keep this die cut. And when I have all the die cuts I want to use, I glue them with my tacky glue or with my edge shave tape to my planner spread. So my shaker page is ready and it's time for the second page in my planner spread because I want to make a double spread, and I also use the dies from Bramble Fox. Here I'm a little bit busy with moving all the pieces, my die cuts, my paper, design paper and my photo. I do this until I'm happy, and then we go to the next step and make also a background from distress oxides and stencils. And here I start ruffled edges with my distress tool because I want to have a little bit more dimension in my work. And I think that I have enough dies I wanted to use, so it's time for some die cuts. I want to use a die cut, but it's not a really big one, because on the other side of this spread I also have use a big die cut, so I want to use a smaller one. But there is so much choice, so I have good looking for the perfect die cut I wanted to use on this side of the spread. And here I found my perfect die cut. So I wanted to use the happy little moments on this side of the planner spread page. So I think I have enough die cuts, I have enough design paper. It's time to use my stamps, because I wanted to use the word memories. And I stamp it with my Arcfor ink on my white cardstock and cut it out. So it's the same thing I did on the other side of the page, and I use also the N word for memories and adventure, because my title of this planner spread is Memories Adventure, or Memories Happy Little Moments and Adventure. So now it's finally time to use my Distress Oxide for the background, and I use the same stencil as at the other side, and I use the same color green, the Distress Oxide peeled paint, and with another stencil I will apply the second color Distress Oxide, and it's also the same second color as on the other side of the planner spread page, and it's the color Seedless Preserves. And for this page I also make some splatter with my Distress Oxide, and I use the color Seedless Preserves. I mix it with some water, and with my brush I made some splatters. here I'm decorating my planner spread page with the die cuts and my picture and design paper, of course. And after this video, I decided to stitch some golden threads through the word adventure. And also on top of this second page, through the note word strips, I stitched some golden thread. And you didn't see that in this video because I decided after the video to do that. Okay, and here I use the word memories. I put them above my photo, and here I use the notebook dies, and I put it above my paper. And of course the little stars, I glue them with my tacky glue on this page. And here I use some word strips Discover Every Day. These word strips are from the Tim Holtz collection, Chit Chat. And I like word strips on my planner spread pages. And I use a black pen and a ruler to make some lines around those word strips. So my planner spread is done, and it's my first planner spread for my Sidekick planner, and I really enjoy making this planner spread. I hope you did too. Here I find a die cut to decorate the inside my planner pocket, and then I'm done. I hope you really enjoy my video, and I hope to see you next time in my next video for our creative journey. Bye bye!